dramatically advanced since November on hopes cooling consumer and producer price index numbers in the U.S. will mean the Federal Reserve is nearing the end of its tightening cycle. Traders pricing in one last 25 basis point hike later this month, a one and done. Philippine shares up 0.75% for the day to back above 6,600 and popped 3.8% for the week, its best in nearly a year. Trader John Mangan still unexcited by the markets, which he says still gives no incentive for investors to buy in.
Growth stocks aren't growing and the value stocks are not adding value. There's no incentive to come into the market right now because, as I said yesterday, investors are going to come in when they see prices going higher or when they see companies coming out with exciting news that's going to increase increase revenues and earnings in the future. And we're not seeing it. I mean, the big stories, MPI list, not list, Wholesome list, D list, it's just... It's a headless chicken right now. All right. The headless chicken is not in a coma, and that's probably a good thing, but we're still running around in circles.
In corporate stories, the APC Group, through its subsidiary, Aragorn Power and Energy Corporation, or APEC, has been officially awarded by the Department of Energy a new geothermal service contract, the Southwest Kalinga Geothermal Power Project. The contract allows for an exploration period of 7 years. This is the second geothermal service contract of APEC, which engages in renewable energy resource exploration. Meanwhile, GoTime President and CEO Nate Clark shares the 9-month-old digital bank will hit the 1 million customer mark by next month and hopes ties with the Gokongwei Group and soon the Ayala Group will allow it to broaden its reach.
Next month, we're going to be crossing the 1 million customer mark. This is kind of just the beginning. I think we've been really excited by our progress. I think that is driven by a few things. Number one, the demand for digital financial services and financial services in general in South Africa is extremely strong. The second thing driving our success to date is the trust of the Gokongwei Group.
Michelle Long, ABC-CBN News.